Hi everyone, John Hardy here with the Video FX update for this Friday, January 28th, 2011. Very interesting Friday with the situation in Egypt and its potential to spread across markets really finally hitting risk appetite. I was discussing with a colleague this morning. I couldn't believe before the open or around the open when we saw the S&P pushing higher towards 1300 after what really wasn't that impressive, a GDP figure out of the U.S., and that we were fully ignoring the potential for this geopolitical situation to affect markets. And suddenly, within minutes after that, after sort of throwing my hands up in disgust, we get a market reaction, I think very justified there. The potential trajectory of this is unknown. It's highly important. It's affecting crude prices heavily. That quickly serves as a tax on the economy, etc. So we need to follow our news services this weekend, that's for sure, and be aware that this situation could easily continue and could get worse. Let's hope not, but let's all be in recognition of the potential there. If we look at Eurodollar, we're seeing that the reversal in risk appetite and the reversal in Eurodollar here in the local sense very much coordinated. The 618 level actually holding quite well. We had a brief piercing of that 618 level yesterday, but that's holding. And although we do still have plenty of chance for this to retrace, I think a 382 Fibo for this small move from here to here is something like 135.60. There's even more room if we look down here. The real key level was this 134.30 area, which was a support on the way down, and then it turned into resistance level in recent history. And that's one level I would look at. If we close below that, that's when we know that the Eurodollar squeeze is over with. And it wasn't just a Eurodollar selling off today. Really, the euro feeling it across the board. If we look at something like euro sterling, the attempt to new highs here above 86 and 50 and change, failing from all intents and purposes today, we still have a big local impulse higher that we need to erase before we can say that the local move here is over with. But this sets up the expectation that this is a resistance area here, the highs, and we'll be looking next at the 200-day moving average, which has been really important for euro sterling. In general, though, I would suspect if we're going to see an end to the euro squeeze, which I would expect anyway fairly soon, that this one at least stays range-bound for now. Now, in crosses like euro Swiss, and if we look at Swiss franc and Japanese yen in general, the looking for safety across markets, the search for safe havens has seen people finally bidding up bonds again, and this supports the lowest yielders, not just the dollar, but also the Swiss franc and the Japanese yen. We had dollar Swiss and dollar yen virtually unchanged on the day. Very interesting setup, actually, on euro Swiss. If we look at the local daily here, you could argue a head and shoulders formation, which could set up a 618 retracement towards 126.60. If we take euro Swiss out to a weekly chart, however, we don't look for tremendous potential to the downside immediately anyway, because of the rally taking out the old low here, and that suggests that we're merely looking for a throwback kind of sell-off. We'll take it one day at a time. Needless to say, very interesting locally on the daily that Euroswiss sold off in the manner it did. This being an event-driven market, though, we have to be aware, of course, that event, the news can actually drive the market, so we need to be careful there. Eurian, also a very interesting chart on the daily. 200-day moving average broke recently. A tremendous bar down today, engulfing the last several days of action. Seeing it stop close to an interesting area today. We're right near the New York close as we're broadcasting this. And the Ichimoku level here on the daily is at 111.85. Quite a reversal of fortune there. I would argue the pressure still to the downside as long as interest rates are falling, that we see those bunds continuing to rally. And interesting also, if we take it out to a weekly, we see a very, very nice test of a weekly Ichimoku cloud level, which came in. Don't have a level here for you, but the high 113s, it was almost 114, looks like. The Ichimoku level is slightly higher than that. That will be a key resistance level as well going forward. You don't want to see that. I'll take you to the next round of charts, which is here. And again, along the lines of the Euro-Swiss and the Euro-Yen charts, we do get support for the lowest yielders with rallying interest rates. We're seeing this in all parts of the curve, yield curve. New low today being rejected and a strong rally engulfing the previous day. So this is a key point, a key pivot point here, and if it follows through, then that suggests some further pressure, I think, on the euro squeeze and for the low-yielding currencies in general. Elsewhere on the yen crosses, another direction change for the yen. We've argued recently as well, part of the yen squeeze lower was on the Japanese sovereign debt situation. We looked at that yesterday and suggested that the currency market was reacting far more than was justified in any case by the bond market, which hardly was ruffled at all by the S&P downgrade. So we saw this action reversing. We're back to where we started from. Very interesting 82 level here on dollar yen. We see if this follows through in the coming days. Pressure to the downside as well here with any continued rally in fixed income, and that means, of course, falling yields. Sterling yen, also interesting, 200-day moving average was touched yesterday, massive rejection, close to Ichimoku, cloud support on the daily, interesting stuff there. And finally, Kiwi yen also, a new high attempt above 64, pretty roundly rejected here. And now we look towards this 200-day moving average in black for the next possible levels of interest. You can see start to see some trend lines across here if you're interested in drawing those. Looking at the some of the major dollar crosses elsewhere, very interesting to see dollar Canada closing around parity today. A key element now in place for argument for further upside. Now we've talked about, we did an article yesterday looking at the valuation of dollar Canada versus a few factors, and said that it should be trading a bit higher relative to at least West Texas Intermediate oil prices and interest rates spreads as well. Now, of course, we've had a massive spike higher in oil today because of the situation in Egypt and the potential for the Suez Canal to close. However, risk appetite by far trumps any rise in oil prices, and the rise in oil prices that has to support Canada would only be in the case of strong global growth. If oil prices are increasing because of geopolitical tensions, you have an entirely different scenario, and that is actually damaging for any pro-risk currency. So regardless of oil prices, if the risk trade is off and we're consolidating in risk, we're most likely to see dollar Canada headed higher. I would argue looking at across the last few times it's tried rally, that this 200-day moving average, very important, it's around 102.50. Cable, also finding some resistance, 160, very important area. Also interesting that we've never really been able to hold above this 159 level properly. A bit of a messy range, but generally the pressure clearly more favorable for the dollar than for the sterling with risk aversion. Though I would suspect sterling in general versus other crosses could be relatively resilient, not against the yen or the dollar, but against euro and Aussie and all these other currencies. If we continue with the risk aversion trade. In the case of Australian dollar and Kiwi, we're seeing very little interest, and I think part of that being the lateness of this move. We didn't get really going until after the U.S. equity opening. By then, the Antipodes are well into their weekend festivities, and I think this is often the case on a late Friday trade. So if we're opening in an ugly fashion on Monday, we could see some extra volatility on top as the Australian dollar and Kiwi dollar play a little catch-up. And one interesting cross on that note is the Kiwi Noki, which we've pointed out a couple of times. Looks value strongly relative to interest rates. And here we have the Kiwi Noki in red versus the blue being the interest rate spread. And we noted that this spread was falling rapidly when Kiwi and versus Noki was rather high here. We noted again somewhere in this area when the spread had fallen further, and it fell again. Now we've got Kiwi Noki trading higher once more, even though the spread is at an all-time low relative to the last couple of years. This is interesting stuff. I think the pressure very much to the downside, and I think sometimes the market gets inefficient when you have a risk aversion event, if you will, like this one. I recall back in the initial days of the massive deleveraging in September, October of 08, we had a crazy spike in Aussie Kiwi that was largely driven simply by the market positioning being so incredibly overdone in the Aussie, and it was the high momentum trade. Let me take you back to that if you can bear with me for a second. So here we have Aussie Kiwi. As the world is falling apart, Kiwi should, theoretically, all other things being equal, should be falling by just as much or even more than the Australian dollar because of its smaller size, less liquidity, what have you. But clearly the market not positioned for that, as it was very heavily into the Aussie yen trade, the Aussie yen carry trade. And we saw an incredible inefficiency that was wiped out in subsequent months. But just something to note: whenever the market gets inefficient, you can look for the trades that don't make any sense out there. And speaking of the Aussie Kiwi, again, we're interested in this top, whether this is going to be a cyclical bear market we're going into on Aussie Kiwi. With that, I wish you a wonderful weekend. Let's keep our eyes glued to the news services this weekend. This is an unusual set of events for us. This market has been so focused on the whole liquidity trade, QE2, what's the Fed going to do next? And here we have something coming completely out of left field that has real black swan potential. So we really need to be on our toes what the implications here are for this. I don't think the market is really ready for an event like this. So if things do continue to spiral out of control, and especially if there's contagion across the region, we could see far more volatility than we've seen so far. So on that note, be very careful out there and have a wonderful weekend. Over and out.